Hey guys, thank you so much for stopping by the channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to merge the air racing suit or the racing suit belts onto components on your female character. So in order to do this, we're going to be transferring some merge components from our male character, and then we're going to merge them on our female. So the first thing you need to do is set up these outfits on the male character. So I'm going to give you a couple examples in this video. It's kind of limited to the tops you can merge this onto. Then I'm also going to give you an example of merging just the special belts with different kinds of shoes on your female character. And then also giving you an example of how to do the bikini tops or the fitted suit jackets as well. So the first thing you're going to do is set up the merge component outfits. And for these outfits, you're going to be using the Fruity Plaid Untucked shirt. This is going to allow you to merge the racing suit belt onto the tops that you can choose on the male character that equal jackets that go over this top. So the racing suit belt is considered a t-shirt, which is why we're using a shirt underneath of these jackets to merge the racing suit belt onto these components. So like I said, you are kind of limited to the styles or the types of tops that you can get for the female character using components, but you still have tons of options. The few that I'm going to be showing you are going to be some checkered items. I'm going to show you bikini tops. I'm also going to be showing you the coverall tops, and then I'm also going to be showing you the track jackets. Now, if you've done my merges before, you know that when you use components for the track jacket, you can change that to any open style jacket when you're back on the female character. So that makes it even more customizable, even if there aren't necessarily components for that on the male character. So when you're using this component here that does have the Fruity Untucked plaid shirt and then whatever jacket you're putting that actually goes over this to make components, you can customize this outfit. You can add components for joggers, you can add components for checkered pants, you can add components for stockings. You're not limited to the style of pants you can wear with this when you're using components. You can also add merge components to this for merging shoes. If you try to merge pants, you're going to end up merging over those racing suit pants, which if you like that, be my guest. You can put that on there if you want. And then if you're trying to wrap your head around or trying to do something where you're also merging gloves with this, that's more complicated merging. I'm not going to show that in this video, but I will feature an outfit that kind of looks like that with emerging gloves or merging just other stuff onto this in a future video that shows complicated merging and how to set up those outfits and kind of how to do that, or at least give you an example so you can wrap your head around it. But for this first outfit, I'm just going to save this in slot number two. So the reason I'm saving this in slot number two now is I suggest putting that racing suit outfit when you're back on your female after transferring components in slot number one. Do not try to save
Don't.
the racing suits on your male in the slot before. It's not going to transfer over as a racing suit belt. So you're doing this when you're back on your female character. So here are the three outfits that I set up when I was first testing this. Just want to give you an example. There's the checkered outfit components, there's the joggers, and then there's the stockings. I'll leave each individual outfit component for the outfits that you do see here in the description, and I'll kind of leave what they are or what they were attached to. So once you've done whatever component transfer glitch is available that you can find in the description, you will load back on as your female character. And you can save your current outfit, whatever you're wearing, which I always do. And then you can now set up the outfits that have the racing suit belts that you wanted to merge over to the components that you transfer. So you've got tons of options in the air racing suit belt. You've got different colors, so you can actually make some cool outfits with the colors that actually match. And then you've also got the basic colors in the racing suit. You've got like dark green, there's light gray, there's black, there's white, and then I think there's navy blue. So you know that we can already get those racing suit belts using just regular components and then a couple of items that we could actually match that with and combine that with to get the racing suit belt. The reason why this glitch is different and more unique is you can use any color of these racing suit belts to merge onto these outfits, which is much different, and you have much more options for the actual tops you can merge onto this. So again, you can set these outfits up however you want it, whatever colors you want it to do. Just make sure you're saving that either in the spot before or after the merge component outfit. For this video, like I said, I'm just going to be doing it before because I've been getting more used to merging to outfits that are after, or sorry, before the merge component. It's just working out a little better for me, especially when I'm doing more complicated merging. So once you've got these set up, what you're going to do is go under jobs and you're going to start up a Rockstar Created Versus job called Crooked Cop. Now, if you know about merging, you really don't need to watch at least this part where I'm showing you how to merge, but definitely stay tuned for later in the video where I'm going to be showing you some other things. And I'll try to explain this to make it sense later in the video. So you're going to set this to player-owned clothing. That's very important, or you will not be able to merge your outfits. Once you've got it set on player-owned clothing, go down to confirm settings, and you're going to invite randoms, friends, doesn't matter. Just as a tip, I turn matchmaking on, I auto-invite, and then I usually invite skill match players, and I get people to join pretty quickly. And then you're going to load into the job. When you load into the job, scroll down to current outfit, and now you're going to scroll to the racing suit and then over to the outfit you wanted to merge that belt with. You'll see that it merges together with each outfit, just depending on whatever air racing suit or racing suit belt I had on before that merge component. And then once you're satisfied with whatever outfit you're doing, if you're doing your first, your second, your third one, whatever it might be, just hit ready to play. So the first outfit that I'm going to be doing and showing you was just going to be the one with the tracksuit top with the joggers. I also merged the racing suit shoes onto this from that outfit and the racing suit belt. And then when you load into the job, you're going to open up your interaction menu, go to style, go to accessories, go to gear, and you're going to add a rebreather. Once you've got the rebreather added to your outfit, you're just simply going to quit the job through your phone and then load back into a GTA Online session where you need to go to ammunition or a clothing store or your apartment and quickly save this outfit. Once you've got the outfit saved, I'm just going to show you here that you can change the tops on the track jackets to any open jacket. The ones you can change it to are the ones that typically you can do with like the no bra glitch on the female character. So you've got tons of options here. You can change to a lot of the suit jackets. You can change to track jackets, smart jackets, some of the newer bomber and work jackets, overcoats, denim jackets, leather jackets. You have tons of different options to the types of tops you can actually change this over to. So depending on what racing suit belt you're using, you may find some things that match a little better instead of that white track jacket. Or if you just want to customize the outfit more, you have a ton more options here when you're using the component for this white track jacket. Or you can leave it as it is. You know, it really just depends on what you like. So once you've got this outfit saved and selected, you will simply just go back into Crooked Cop to merge together the rest of your outfits. You have to do this for each individual outfit when you're merging them together. So I'm not sure if I made that very clear in other videos, but you cannot just merge every outfit in the job and then expect to come out and have all them merge. You have to complete the merge for each outfit, add the rebreather, quit the job, save it. So that can take a little time if you don't got someone helping you with Crooked Cop, but hopefully you guys are getting through it just fine. There's tons of people in Crooked Cop right now doing these glitches. So the next outfit I was just going to show you quickly was going to be the checkered outfit that I merged some of the yellow items onto. I featured this on Instagram. I really like the way this outfit looks. I think it looks pretty cool. And then you can just merge hats and masks and whatever onto that as well. So this is another outfit that I am showing you that had merge shoe components as well as some stockings and then that track jacket on top of it. And then I merged the race belt and those race shoes onto it. Now I wanted to give you an example of how I was able to get different shoes that don't normally have components with this racing suit belt also merged onto these stockings. So what I did is after I exited the job, I saved the outfit. And then you can change the pants, you can change the shoes, and it will not make the racing suit go away. So all I did was I went over to the shoe section, I changed to those cherry plain high top sneakers, and then I re-saved that outfit that had the racing suit belt now that was merged and those shoes onto the slot that originally had the racing suit that I saved on female. So I saved over that. So then what I did was I wanted to be able to merge that racing suit belt and then those cherry plain high top sneakers back onto these stockings that had merge components attached. And then I also, of course, wanted to merge over that racing suit belt again onto that outfit. So I saved this again. I saved this over the slot that I had saved the racing suit on originally. I just really wanted to be able to merge together different shoes with this because I really don't like those racing suit shoes, to be honest. I think they're too big, and you know, my female doesn't have that big of feet. You know, she's got little cute feet. So once you do this, you're just going to do the same step again, where you're going to open up a Rockstar created versus job called Crooked Cop, and then you're just going to merge that outfit together. And then because you had that tracksuit on, you can change this to any open style of jacket. So there's tons of options. If you looked on Instagram and you saw the outfit that I uploaded, you know that I eventually chose a denim jacket with the red attached to it, and then just kind of set up a hat and a mask glitch to go with that, and it looked really good together. So I wanted to show that in this video because I know there are probably going to be questions about that, especially if you've seen my Instagram post. And then the last thing I'm going to be showing you is complicated. So if you've watched the merging trash vest video, you know that we can merge together some bikini tops with the trash vest, right? So what I ended up doing was I used those same components for the bikini top and the trash vest to merge the racing suit belts onto that. So I didn't merge together the trash vest, and this is complicated. I really don't want to explain it in this video, but when you're merging together an item that doesn't have the trash vest already onto it, onto those bikini tops, which is why I told you guys to do the varsity jackets before, you will lose the trash vest. That's how I was able to get the bikini tops without the trash vest with the gloves. Just hint, hint, I will be showing that in a future video. But for this one here, I'm going to be showing you how to get the bikini top with the racing suit belt without the trash vest. So you just need to set that up with the same top components. I'll leave those in the description. And then you're just simply merging over the race belt to this outfit. The only weird thing about it is you're limited to the type of bottoms you can wear with this, at least when you're transferring. So the only options you really have are either merge pants, skirts, or some suit pants. So because of that, you really don't necessarily, I think, want to merge together the racing suit pants with the bikini top. Unless you like the way that looks, you can use the merge pants. Or if you just wanted to do the white continental pants, do that, and then you can change the pants when you're back on your female character. If you're wanting to do joggers or stockings or something else with that bikini top, I'm still working on that. And if you wanted to do that, I will feature that, hopefully, if I can figure it out, in an upcoming video that I'm going to be working on that's going to have 3 to 5 really complicated merging outfits. And I hopefully will have that out soon. And I just wanted to give that or feature that for people that are really comfortable with merging and maybe want more ideas on just how to make more customizable outfits. So that's it for this video. Hopefully this made a little more sense to you on how I was merging the racing suit belts onto different tops. Those colorful racing suit belts that we've always wanted that don't have components. But make sure you drop a like, please subscribe, leave me lots of comments, check the description before you ask questions, and I will see you soon in more glitch videos.